All right, we are working on more on that Barney Frank story, that quote from him that he's looking to abolish Fannie and Freddie in their current form. We're trying to get more details on that. In the meantime, it's been a tough week for the bulls as the Dow has had its worst two-day drop since June. The S&P had its worst one-day drop since October of last year. And that begs the question, are we headed for a correction here? Let's ask Adam Bold, founder of the mutual fund store. We also have Joe Battipaglia, market strategist at Stifel Nicolaus. Thanks to both of you for joining us. Adam, let me ask you, how much jeopardy do you think the market is in if Ben Bernanke does not return? Because I think that's a question that's open for debate. There's been a lot of assumptions that we would see the market tank. Do you think that's true?
Maybe in the short term, one thing I know is that the market doesn't like uncertainty. And if we don't know who the next Fed chairman is going to be, that certainly adds another wrinkle. But, you know, I'm not really getting upset about a 300 or 400 point decline in the market. The reality is that we've come off a recession, and different companies have responded to that in different ways, some very good, some very poorly. And when you get mixed results, you're going to get mixed results in the market. And as much as I'd like things to go up every day, that just doesn't happen.
Joe B., what's cooking here? Is it possible that stronger economic news is not good for stocks, i.e. China credit tightening, the possibility if the Fed figures out who its chairman is, they might have an earlier exit strategy, and the stock market is just real jittery about higher short-term rates and less monetary stimulus from both China and the U.S.? Is that possible, Joe?
Well, clearly, China's decision to ratchet down their expansion has ramifications globally for demand for commodities. It has implications for credit. But in the United States, the central issue is whether or not you have a robust economic expansion from here or something that's rather mediocre. And at the same time, analysts in prior quarters who were very pessimistic on their earnings have now gotten emboldened and have too much built into their expectations. So what I see in 2010 is an economy that's simmering down to a much slower growth rate, no V-shaped recovery, earnings that don't come in to the full expectation of analysts for the course of the year, the uneven withdrawal of government intervention in the economy. We already have the Council of Mayors clamoring for another stimulus plan, for example, and the Fed has to consider whether to continue the quantitative easing. Both of those are not signs of a robust recovery. So there is the central problem. That's why stocks tend to move sideways when that kind of uncertainty surfaces.
So, Adam, what do you do here as you see stocks leveling off after 2 days of declines? What would you do?
Well, I don't know what's going to happen in the next few days. I expect that the market will be markedly higher between now and the end of the year. So I happen to be an extraordinarily patient guy. And, you know, I don't like it when things go down, but I can sit through these weeks and not panic because I know I have great investments for our clients.
Not panic, but what does that mean? Are you adding to some positions when you see dips? What are you doing specifically?
Yeah, clearly, this is a time when I'm not afraid to put new money into the market.
Okay.
It just doesn't worry me.
Joe, how about yourself? Because, you know, you've been a bear on this story, but you've also been nibbling from time to time. You look at this story in the front page of the Wall Street Journal investment section. The really hardest hit stocks have been the basic resources. Let's just call it commodities and energy and industrials, although the big banks, too. Is there buying opportunities there, Joe? I mean, suppose you have relatively moderate growth for the rest of the year. That ain't bad.
No, it's not bad, but certainly the risk trade becomes less appealing because commodity prices may wane in the face of weak demand and relatively high supply, and looking for quality of balance sheets as opposed to where the most leverage lie, which is really the play in banks to this point. And for investors to think that you would get a free pass for all the government interventions, particularly on bank earnings, without there be retribution at some point, is really kind of ridiculous.
Would you short the banks, Joe? You read the front pages like everybody else. Would you short the banks?
We've scaled back our exposure to banks because it is true they will eventually be lowering their reserve provisions for losses. Hopefully this credit crisis will abate at some point. They can have better earnings, but the regulatory framework will be different. Their costs, whether it be FDIC fees or otherwise, will be higher, so there'll be some friction there. And we put more money to work in healthcare, interestingly enough, because now the government has moved away from the public option, and now you've got a better landscape to make choices there.
We got to leave it there, guys. Thanks so much for joining us.